we both get to be here this time. So this is really exciting, Andy. Not only do I get to be up on stage this year, but I get to present the first award, which is very exciting and fancy for me.
And fancy for you. Fancy yes. for me, too. They never let me up on stage. The category is the Community Group and Not-for-Profit Association Grassroots Category. It recognizes particular environmental initiatives led by volunteers, community groups, not-for-profit, or professional associations that demonstrate the commitment to the environment and has produced measurable and sustained positive change.
Please enjoy these videos.
The Heartland Beautification Committee is a group of volunteers. Our mission is keeping Stettler clean and green, green in the sense of beautiful plants and green in the sense of eco-friendly. So some of the projects that we do, for example, we have Trash to Treasure Days, repair cafes. We even have cigarette butt recycling here. We've so far in a year recycled 20,000 cigarette butts. Some of our programs have showed very measured success. Our Bring Your Own Bag program has seen a 20% reduction in the single-use plastic bag usage. We've also seen a doubling in our walk and roll participation, a doubling in the number of people who choose to leave their car at home and walk or bike to their destination. This year, we're taking it outside of the community, and we are challenging the town of Ponoka to a walk and roll, and then at the end of the summer, we'll announce who has walked or biked the most. The Heartland Beautification Committee is thrilled to be nominated for an Alberta Emerald Award. What we hope to gain from this nomination is a higher profile on what we do, that we are showing other communities in Alberta that these are things that can be done, and we can each as a community address our local areas and make a difference in our world one local community at a time.
Sustainable Me is a six-part, 20-minute documentary series. The six shows look at subjects of food, water, housing, transportation, economy, and resilience. And we profile young people in the city who are doing actionable things. They're all inspiring, and put together, they give an impressive look at how we can engage sustainably. The people that we met inspired the show. Once we started meeting people who were doing interesting and intriguing things, it just snowballed. We want all viewers to walk away inspired. We want especially young people who have ideas to be energized to take the next step and maybe put their ideas into action and move towards living more sustainably. I'm immensely honored and very proud to have the work of our team nominated for an Emerald Award. I mean, it's a pretty prestigious and highly respected honor. It's quite amazing.
Decentralized Energy Canada is a national industry association that helps match the technology pioneers in the decentralized energy space with the project opportunities, with investors, with municipalities that are looking at being more self-sufficient in terms of energy in the future.
We also work with funding organizations. We also help our members to get investment, so it's very variable, and it really depends on what our members need, and then we help them.
So we have over 10,000 in our network now, 15 years later, across Canada. So it's creating a united, stronger voice for the industry. So our energy infrastructure is actually aging. It's an 80-year-old infrastructure. Our generation systems are largely 80 to 100 years old. I think we're transitioning now into understanding that efficiency is important, that reducing emissions and protecting our environment is important, and that there are several technology options available to us to produce energy in a clean and efficient way that's also affordable. We're seeing a lot of progress in this industry, and now is the time for us to really jump forward and reform our energy system and do something new and innovative. Thank you very much to the Alberta Emerald Foundation for this award. We're extremely pleased and honored to be recipients of it. And we have many people to thank. NMAX Energy has been a very strong supporter since we were founded. EPSAB, Iguana Technologies, Equus REA, and Lakeland College. I'd like to thank them very much for nominating us this year. So we have a very diverse group of people to thank, and all of our members that have supported us and helped us get through some very challenging times, and I think the future is looking pretty bright for this, the decentralized energy industry. And again, I'd like to thank the Alberta Emerald Foundation for making this a reality for us. It's very important.
Accepting for Decentralized Energy Canada are Anouk Kendall, Anna Medina, Patricia Bourne, Diane Harms.
Bring it right back. I just think it's funny how it goes. Now I'm on the